Hello, and today we are with Nora Gasparini, who is the founder of L'Atelier Parfums and Creations here in Bali, Indonesia. Good morning to you, Nora.
Good morning, sir.
Now, I'm very excited to be doing this interview with you today because you go to a lot of hotels and the boutiques that are available to guests are really relatively boring. But yours, I find, is a unique selling point for the property because it's something that they really can benefit from. Could you tell us a little bit about the company and what made you start it, please?
Yeah, sure. L'Atelier Parfums and Creations is a new way to enjoying Indonesia. The idea is to offer the opportunity to create your own perfume and discover Indonesia and Bali through fragrances.
Now, in terms of that, when you say that, first of all, why did you choose the Ritz-Carlton? Because you have a couple of properties, right? You have the Ayana and there's the Ritz-Carlton here as well. Why did you choose this for your second shop?
Actually, this is the Ritz-Carlton who asked me to come, so I couldn't refuse, of course.
Now, how can guests benefit from your products? What is it that you do here?
We do custom perfume, and also we sell our own perfume or fragrance, but the guests can create their own perfume through their personality, and also they can discover all the fragrances that are available in Indonesia and Bali.
What is the process if a guest wants to create his or her own perfume? What is the process and how long does it take?
We have two different workshops. We have the first one where the assistant will develop the perfume with you, and we have another one which is you will be the one who will create and discover all the fragrance. So the first one in around 20 minutes and the second one is about 1 hour up to 1.5 hours.
And what happens during that time? What do they do?
We start with a questionnaire about your personality, the things that you like to do, activities, and the place where you like to go. And after we will propose you some fragrances and you will select the ones that you like. And after we will show you how to create eau de toilette, eau de parfum, different type of perfume, and you will have to choose which one you like.
With these ingredients, where are they coming from? Do you source everything locally or do you have to import some products?
80% of all the organ come from Indonesia, all over Indonesia, but also we have like the key component like bergamot, for example, the lavender that we import from France, Italy.
Now, of course, the nose here is very important. Some people in France, where you're from originally, Martinique, you have to learn to a lot of training to be able to use your nose correctly to create perfumes. How do you do that in such a short period of time with the hotel guests?
You know, like you are the one who can decide if you like it or no, and that, I think that the most important things, if the impression that you want to give, and I cannot decide for you for this. But what I did before that, when you arrived to the shop, I create activity where you don't have to think about these kind of things. The only thing that you have to think is, do I like it or not? And after I will show you, I will help you, I will get you.
Now, of course, a lot of guests coming here will be coming internationally. They go through duty-free. At duty-free, you have eau de toilette, you have eau de parfum. And what are you offering here? Do you offer eau de parfum or is it eau de toilette? How does that work in terms of the actual finished product?
Depends on what you want to have. Of course, I'm going to show you how to create the eau de toilette and eau de cologne, that sometimes we call, and also eau de parfum, and then you will have to decide. It depends on what you when you want to use your perfume and in which occasion. So it really depends on the person.
How does it differ? Because somebody like myself who doesn't understand colognes or perfumes very much, I'm always told that the eau de parfum is the better one to buy. But that's probably duty-free just to try to sell me the more expensive one. How does it actually work? And what would you recommend for use in terms of eau de toilette and eau de parfum?
Eau de toilette is something that you can wear during the day and to refresh yourself. And eau de parfum will be more for the night or for a special occasion, for example. But some people also like to wear eau de parfum during day just because they like the perfume overpowering them. So I would recommend, it all depends during the workshop. You will feel if you prefer a certain type, but I don't think that there is one better than the other one.
In terms of sizes, of course, some people are restricted in terms of duty-free when they do travel back to their home country. What sizes of perfumes do you offer here at the shop?
We have two sizes, the 30 milli bottles, that's the ones you get during your workshop, or you can have the 60 milli, and that's the upgrade. Both can be can be bought in the airplane.
And what sort of prices are we looking at here?
The short workshop is around $60, the 20 minutes, or you have the $80 where you have all the whole process, including the perfume.
Right. Now, one question I do have for you is some people seem to be able to smell lovely all day long with their aftershaves and perfumes and what have you, whereas when I tend to put it on, it tends to disappear after about, that might be the reason I'm sweating so much. But why is it that some perfumes last longer than other brands? Some brand of perfumes last longer, and what type of perfume is it you're selling here?
It's difficult to smell good all day here in Bali, for example, because it's really hot and the perfume tend to disappear very quickly because it's evaporation, basically. Or also, if you sweat too much, then you will wash up the perfume as well. But it also depends on the chemistry with your skin. Some people tend to bring out more the citruses, more the flower. It really depends on your chemistry.
Who is this shop proving popular with? What nationalities are coming here the most to make use of your services?
Here we are working with the people who come to the hotel. So we are working with Chinese people, of course, with Japanese and with Australian. But depends on the location. Sometimes also we work more with European, with American. Depends on the season as well.
Now, in Chinese market, you mentioned there, language is a very important issue. They don't always speak the best English. How are you managing that in terms of helping them? And are you using technology to help you?
Of course, during the workshop, it's always the same one that we use. So our assistants are trained with the words, with the sentences that we usually use. Unfortunately, we are not bilingual, but all the documents are available in different languages.
The percentage of men and women, how many women are using your services and how many women, and how does it compare men versus women?
I know that you will be surprised, but we have 50-50.
Really?
Yes. And the reason is the workshop, not the perfume itself, but the workshop. Men tend to like to play with drops and chemistry, you know. So I was surprised myself as well. I create the workshop for the woman, and I end up with a lot of men as well. So. Yeah, it's available for everybody, and even the children, boys and girls.
Now, for men, of course, the products are slightly different. We might like an aftershave or even an aftershave gel or an oil. Are you able to go into those type of products as well, or is it just perfumes?
It's the aftershave or the cologne, as you call it, is that depends on the ingredients that you use, and we have them here, so you can create your aftershave with no problem.
Which of the products are proving more popular with women, and which are the more popular with men?
Of course, we will tend to for men we will tend to use more woods and spices, and for women flower and fresh scents like citrus, and for men as well, citrus is popular. Yeah.
Now, what time does the shop open and close? And are people able to make reservations with you? Because you do have a limited number of seats. Are they able to make a reservation for your services before they arrive?
Of course. You can go to our website. I don't know if you can put the website, but it's perfumeworkshop.com. And you can just book online, and we will be able to assist you with that. Or you can just show up here. And if we have availability, of course, we are happy to help you.
Now, if a guest wants a little bit more privacy than the shop affords, are you able to offer this service in the suites of the guest as well?
Of course, we can offer the workshop in the suite. We already did it, and it's good.
Now, of course, if somebody falls in love with your fragrances, they're going to want to keep buying it. Once they've left, what options are available to them? Are they able to? Do you keep the particular recipe that they've created, and are you able to order online?
Of course. We keep all the formulas. So even if you tend to choose some things that you didn't previously choose, we are able to redo it as well. So you can reorder the ones that you already created or the ones that you missed.
How long do you keep the recipes for, or the formulas, as you say?
They are here until we are we exist.
And finally, this concept does sound very exciting, because it gives the guests a little bit of fun. It gives them something unique. It's different. It's a bit like a cooking class, but more interesting. In that sense, do you have any expansion plans? What are your expansion plans here in Bali and regionally?
Of course, we are looking to expand ourselves. So we are looking to open here in Indonesia or outside Europe or Asia. We are open to any proposition.
Is your focus on the hotels, to work with the hotels?
Yes.
Rather than in shopping malls?
Yes.
And why is that?
It's just because we like to offer like an experience, and I think that hotel, and especially luxury hotel like Ritz-Carlton, offer this type of experience.
Excellent. Well, unknown Nora, I have to say thank you very much indeed for your time today. It's been fascinating to learn more about your company, and of course I wish you and L'Atelier Parfums and Creations the best of luck for the future.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.